Hello, and welcome to 5 minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to talk about incremental view maintenance, as well as the upcoming Postgres 15 beta release. So first of all, this is a new extension released by the SRA OSS team in Japan, which is called pgivm. pgivm is an extension you could install today on your production server, but I wouldn't recommend it because it's still early days. This extension was released in its 1.0 release about 6 days ago. It's a version of the incremental view maintenance feature that the SRA OSS team has been working on for a while, and it's intended for Postgres 14 only, not usable on older releases. This lets you create incremental materialized views as the table changes, they're refreshed automatically. The idea is that instead of you having to run refresh materialized view, which you can do today in Postgres, this does the updates automatically. The difference between a regular view and a materialized view is that a materialized view keeps a copy of the data, versus a regular view is essentially just a different lens of looking at the data. If you create a materialized view, you actually create a copy, whereas in a regular view, you go back to the original tables. Benefit, of course, is that the data that's structured in a materialized view may be much faster to access because you are able to do a join ahead of time, or you're able to compute certain functions ahead of time. The authors described two different approaches to view maintenance. The first approach being immediate. In immediate maintenance, a view will be updated in the same transaction where the base table is modified. And in deferred maintenance, the materialized view would be updated after the transaction occurred. The challenge they are trying to solve here is that of immediate maintenance, where the materialized view is updated within the same transaction using an after trigger when the base table is modified. The way that you use this extension is through the create imvf function. Imvf stands for incrementally maintainable materialized view. It's essentially a specialized version of materialized view that supports incremental maintenance. Here in this example, you can see they're selecting from the table. There's 3 records in here. They insert into the base table, and then there's 4 records. Happens automatically, no extra work necessary. If you want to use that, it's easily buildable. If you run your own virtual machine, again, I would only use it for testing at this point. Generally, this is a pretty straightforward extension. They do give some performance numbers here as well, where they're comparing a regular materialized view on a 10 million records pgbench table, and then they're updating a single record. Of course, the point here is the update itself is fast, but then I have to call this refresh materialized view, which takes 20 seconds. That's pretty expensive. That means I don't want to run this all the time, versus with the incremental materialized view, you can create it in the same way, but then when you do the update, it updates automatically. There's no extra work necessary. There's a little bit of overhead here. You will actually notice that the update statement here is slightly slower with the materialized view in place. Part of the reason for that is that they have to create an extra index on the base table. There's still a bunch of restrictions here. It does support inner joins, but it doesn't support outer joins. It does support distinct, but it doesn't support window functions or CTEs. For some use cases, it may work today. For others, it may not. What's interesting about this work is that it is related to a patch that's currently being worked on for Postgres itself. The idea behind this is actually an older idea. We can learn more about that by going to the Postgres commit fests. Commit fests are how Postgres tracks its development cycles, and specifically its review cycle. It's where people contribute their patches. For example, you or I could go in there and submit a patch to the next commit fest. That's a peer review type model. The next commit fest is happening in July, and that's actually the first commit fest for Postgres 16. The last commit fest just concluded in March, and now we're in stabilization time for Postgres 15. You could look through the commit fests to see what was committed. When we look ahead, we can see in the next commit fest, if we go for incremental materialized view maintenance, you can see this particular patch, the same authors that wrote the pgivm extension, they are contributing to Postgres itself. And they're trying to make this an official Postgres feature. It's a very complex patch, unfortunately. But the hope is that Postgres 16, not the next release, but the next release, is going to be the time for incremental view maintenance in Postgres. Now, speaking of Postgres 15, Postgres 15 Beta1 is actually around the corner. The current plan from the release management team is that the first beta release is going to be available on May 19th, a little bit over 2 weeks from now. You can get your hands on the first version of Postgres 15 to test. There's still a bunch of open items on Postgres 15, and I'm sure there will be more bugs that are discovered. You can see, for example, some of the open items are related to new JSON features. Other things are certainly worth testing. It's very helpful for a community to get bug reports early, because then they can be fixed in subsequent beta releases before the release candidate and before the eventual release, most likely in September, October, if we can believe the historic numbers. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about new episodes, and talk to you next week.